At Chime, we're making banking better for everyone. Because financial peace of mind should be for people of all kinds. Chime helps people who help, who hoop, MCs of the roots, like me. Cooks who flip flapjacks, whatever your zodiac, Chime's got your back. Chime's making banking better for everyone.
Hey, Rick. Hi.
Yeah, I'm socially distanced. That's why I don't have the mask on. So whoever's watching.
Certainly. Thanks.
I got a reading today from the Equal Justice Initiative calendar. August 1st, 1944, in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, 6,000 white transit employees strike after 8 black men begin training as motormen on streetcars, a job that had been reserved for white men only. So what happened was 6,000 white employees that were the trolley car drivers all called in sick. They called it a sick out. And so what happened was FDR called in military people to run the cars and allowed the 8 black men to continue training and have their jobs. And so after a period of time, all the white people came back to work, and the 8 African Americans kept their jobs. So it was early progress, largely in part due to FDR and civil rights.
Eddie's up first.
Hey, Rick, what kind of mood is everybody in today after a long night last night?
Disappointed, but I think we're going to be determined to bounce back tomorrow.
And if I could follow up real quick, how did you feel about the show of solidarity there before the game and the national anthem, and how that went over and was received?
It was great. It was, you know, everything that's happening here relative to social justice is really super positive. The important thing is to continue with it, continue to have these conversations, continue to talk about these events on the EJI calendar so that we can understand, talk about things, horrible things that have happened in the past, deal with them, and remind ourselves that these things cannot be allowed to continue.
Thank you.
Okay, next up we'll go to Davide.
Hey, Coach, Davide here from Italy. What did you see last night from Kristaps Porzingis? Obviously, his numbers were great, but I'm curious about what you think about his game, what he did good and what he did not so good.
A lot of great things. I liked his activity when he was deep in the paint. He caused a lot of problems. He drew fouls. He finished. He had a couple of and-ones. And so I like his early runs to the rim and shape ups for the ball. And then when he doesn't have that, to get space back out, because the 5 men have to guard him at the 3-point line because he's such a great shooter. But, you know, he got a good start and kept the momentum going pretty well. And, you know, we just need him to continue doing what he's doing.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Next up will be Callie.
Hey, Rick. I know obviously the focus is on the games right now, but how much do you make an effort to stay in touch with the players not in the bubble, and vice versa? How do they kind of stay in the rhythm with the team despite not being in Orlando?
Yeah, I stay in touch via text or calls. You know, Willie had his baby recently, and so called to congratulate him on that. You know, we called we FaceTimed Jalen Brunson before the first scrimmage, you know, several days ago, to let him know that we missed him and see how he was doing. He's doing really well. So, yeah, I mean, that stuff's ongoing. I know the other guys are keeping in touch with those guys as well.
Was the FaceTime with the whole team, or was that more just you and Jalen?
It was me, Jalen, and I think Sham had him on the box. So Sham and I were talking to him. We were back in the coach's area, and we had him on just chatting a little bit before the game.
Gotcha. Thanks.
Okay, we'll go to the questions in the room. We'll go, Brad has one, and then Chris. So, Brad, go ahead.
One of the things that you look to try to tighten up today, and then as part of that, Houston is unorthodox in its lineups. Is that a game tape that you watch very much?
Watched it a couple times today, and watched it last night. A real unfortunate ending based on all the positive things that we were doing. But we've got to make some corrections, you know, with our late game execution at both ends. You know, defensively, we struggled. We missed blockouts, not only the one to tie the game, but there was another big one with Westbrook and, you know, down the stretch in the fourth. And then, you know, we had four turnovers that were pretty much unforced. And then, look, we're going to continue to work on, you know, free throw shooting, and that's obviously a very important part of the game.
Thanks. And final question will be from Chris, who's in the room with you.
A lot of coaches that I've talked to have expressed how much they like the looser wardrobe restrictions for head coaches on the sideline. I mean, how do you feel about, you know, kind of wearing what you get to wear? And do you think it's something that could ever be adopted, you know, moving forward?
Well, I think it's appropriate for this setting, because this is a different setting. We're all in the same place. There's really no fans in the arena. And it's a bit arduous to get dressed up in a coat and tie, you know, given these circumstances. There's been discussion about, you know, polos versus suits for a couple of years. We polled the coaches and the coaches association a couple of years ago, and at that time it was overwhelming in favor of suits. You know, it was probably 2-1. And so I think that's generally the feeling. But I like the league's willingness to be flexible here. You know, this just has a different feel. And so it seems to make sense. And it's not, you know, to be clear, it's not wear whenever you want. I mean, it's you've got to wear a team polo. Your staff's got to be basically all the same, you know, supposed to all be wearing the same color pants. You know, we've got the same shoes for all of our staff. And so, you know, it's still about looking professional, even though, you know, there's no suits.
I think that poll might be different if you did it again after this.
I don't know. I mean, like a lot of things, you know, there tend to be a few loud voices, you know, but the overall, you know, opinion is something that we always find out, you know, just to see what's what, you know. You know, we talk about just about everything we do with respect to things like that, and then you know, those discussions carry over to discussions with the league. So in this case, the league was willing to do polos. I think everybody looks really, really good in them. I think everybody looks professional. And again, I feel like it suits the environment pretty well.
Thanks, Rick.
Yep.